Hello my dear students and friends, welcome to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 16. In today's session I will be using the single video for both this SolidWorks as well as for this PLC with HMI. Okay, now we'll see about today's program is SolidWorks model. I'll be showing this is about a pick and place robotic setup that I developed. It is modeled in SolidWorks, programmed with the help of PLC and HMI touchscreen. So all three integrated together as a single product. Okay, so that is why I said the single video is common for both my SolidWorks as well as the PLC session. Let me show you the model. So this is the model that I developed actually. Okay, so I could say let us say the number of degrees of freedom it has. This particular pneumatic cylinder will move the bed from the inner end to the outer end. So this is 1 degree of freedom. Okay, then the other degree of freedom is the rotation. Rotation we could see from the top. So let me rotate. So this kind of rotation, I am not able to rotate perfectly. So from here it will go that side. 180 degree rotation is possible here. Okay, so that is second degree of freedom. Let me go again. Let me keep it normal. Okay, it is not working now. Let it be. Okay, then the next degree of freedom is it will move down. Here is a gripper. It will take the object. Then it will move. And it moves to some other place, then it moves down, then it drops it. So there is pick and place. Okay, so always I'll show you that this diagram. You know, you see, sorry, yeah, so this is the gripper. Okay, this is the gripper. So always it takes the object from here. Okay, then station 1, station 2 on this side, on the 180 degree other side, station 3, station 4, station 6 are behind this. So there are picking at one place constant, but placing at 5 places. We can choose any one of those 5 places. Place 1 or station 1, station 2, station 3, station 4, station 5. So it is pick and place or vice versa. Place and pick are in the reverse way actually. It takes the object from any one of those 5 stations and it will place here. So both the modes are possible. So like that I developed this particular package. Here I did not use the Mitsubishi compatible PLC. Instead I used one branded Delta PLC actually. This is the Delta PLC that I used. These are the relays actually. Then these are the pneumatic, these are the solenoids that controls the pneumatics, the compressed air setup. Okay, this is the program that we developed. It is nearly having more than 1000 lines. I just press page down, you see how many lines it has. It looks like a very complex program. Of course it is not a complex program, but these many number of lines are required actually to execute this particular program, because pick and place, place and pick, one time, multiple time, there are several options available. So this particular board has roughly 800 steps, 800 memories it has, but I used 1164 steps actually. Okay, so this is the program. The logic for it is available here. Now since I use the HMI, I did not use any of the physical inputs it has. I used physical output Y0 to linear cylinder. So this Y0 is corresponding to in the CAD, this is the one. Okay, here you see that this is the cylinder, this is the cylinder, right? So that is Y0, and rotary cylinder, this is here, the entire setup will rotate actually in the CAD. So this is the one. So this will be about this, it will rotate, this will rotate. Let me rotate once again. So this will rotate. So this is a rotary cylinder. First time I am using the rotary cylinder. Most of us, we haven't seen the rotary cylinder. All along we'll be seeing the linear cylinder only, linear air cylinder. It will have only linear motion. Okay, reciprocatory motion or the linear motion. But this is the rotary pneumatic cylinder. It rotates almost 360 degree, but for me, 180 degree is sufficient. So I used a sufficient stopper to make it to turn it in 180 degree only, right? So that is the thing. Then arm cylinder, in the diagram or in the CAD, this is the arm cylinder. So this will move this cylinder in the up and down direction, arm cylinder. Okay, then gripper cylinder, this is the gripper cylinder, this is the gripper cylinder, this is the cylinder, gripper cylinder, air cylinder actually. This it is on, this will be closer, this will close so that it will pick the object. In the diagram, you see it is in something like a Y shape, you know, it becomes flat. That means it takes the object, right? The stopper solenoid I used to stop it in between. Generally, the pneumatic cylinders is not having positional control, whereas the hydraulic cylinders can be controlled positionally. Every 1 mm or every inch you can position it, but here it is not so, left extreme or right extreme, but in between I need to stop it in midway. So for that I use this cylinder, this one. So if this is actuated, this will not go beyond this. If it is pulled, it can go up to this particular thing. So to stop the entire this bed midway, I used another air cylinder. You can see that in the diagram. Yeah, now you see that in between I use this cylinder. So as far as this logic is concerned, I used only out of 6 outputs I have for this. It is enough for me to have only 5 physical outputs. I used physical output 1, Y0 linear cylinder longitudinal motion, and Y1 rotary cylinder, it will swivel, it will rotate. Y2, the arm will be oscillating, the gripper capture or release the object. Stopper cylinder is to stop in between in the Y traverse. As I said earlier, since I used HMI, I did not use any of the physical inputs it has. So this is about the HMI configuration. I just run through the things. This is about sequencing, sequence of the programming sequence. Rack 1, place. It takes the object from the main origin to the station 1. Placing or picking, it means it takes the object from station 1 to the home position. That is station 2 place, station 2 pick. Station 3 place, station 3 pick. Station 4 place, station 4 pick. Station 5 place, station 5 pick. There are only 5 stations. Auto place means if the auto place is off, it object is placed only once. Auto place is on, it will take the object from the main home position, main place to the origin to the place that you are selecting repeatedly. So this is how I made the program. It is a professional program. It is my daughter's final year project work. Myself and my daughter together, we did this project. It took nearly 2 months time to complete it. but everything is modeled in SolidWorks. So now you are seeing the SolidWorks assembly now, SolidWorks assembly, right? Then these are the, this is the program that we did it, and it is fused in the thing. For that, this is the logic. Before writing this program, we have written the logics in the Word file. So based on the logics only, we wrote the program, okay? So each and everything is a block, so it will be repetitive. Take for example the place, you see, first the arm is for the for placing the object from the home position to the initial origin station to the station 1, arm down, gripper on, gripper on, then arm up, stopper on, because it should not go to the end position, at the midway it has to stop, so in between stopper is on, then linear or the longitudinal motion is on, then arm down, then gripper off, that means the object is released, then arm up, then it goes to the home position. So this is the logic, okay? So the space which is which has left as blank, you know, that means it is off. These things will be on only on these occasions. For example, arm down, at the auxiliary memory 11th position, arm down is on. That's all. That's all. Okay. So something like that. Okay. So the auxiliary memory also we allocated uniquely. Now we see those things in action. Let me show you this one now. This is the image. You see that these many buttons we have provided. This is a HMI actually. So you can, if it can be start, you can mode is one time or continuous, place or pick, station 1, station 2, station 3, station 4, station 5. Auto means it will be continuous. If it is on, it is continuous. If it is off, only one time. Auto pick, again, one time or continuous. This is the emergency button provided. This is HMI. So HMI is connected with the PLC. Yeah, this is the station point. That is origin point or home position, station, yeah. Now you see that, place 1, second position, I selected second, it takes there, then maybe third position, it rotates now, it goes to station 3, and this is station 4 now. So now I could say it is everything is a one-time operation, not automatic or not continuous. Maybe in the next video, now I kept all the five, all, now in this video you'll be seeing the five objects are provided in five stations. Okay, it is auto pick. You can start the timer also. I think everything will be completed in 25 seconds. One is picked and placed here. I mean, the second is being picked. Third. Fourth. And finally, the fifth. Now, you see, the timer, you see the 30 seconds, you know, now let me play once again. You see 22 or 23 seconds, all the five objects were picked, right? This is auto pick mode. Auto place mode we will see. I have to keep one after the other now. I placed one time, place the second time, second station, the third station. I have to keep it here, fourth, and finally the fifth. Okay, so this is how we made the thing actually. Again, let me show you. This is the robotic arm for the example. There is, it is something like a library book actually, a book or the object. Okay, let me repeat once again. This button is to start. This button mode one time or mode automatically. This automatic is different. This automatic is different. This automatic will be, for example, if whether it is one time or automatic, you have to choose any one of those five. Either the rack one, rack two, station one, station two, station three, station four, station five. Choose any one. Then one time means press it. It takes the object and say, for example, if you have selected rack two, for example, if we start, it takes the object from the main origin to the station two. One time means that's all. It will come to go home position. If it is automatic here, so it will be, this will be, it takes the object from the origin, takes the object, it keep the object at the station two. So this cycle will be repetitive endlessly, continuously. So that is the thing. This one, place or pick. Now it is place. That means it takes the object from the origin, it places the object at the station that you are choosing. So if it is pick, it picks the object from the any one of the station that you are selecting. Then it pick and it will put in the origin place. So that is the thing. This auto place, it will be taking the auto place means it will take the object from the origin. First time it takes keeps it in the station one. Second time keeps it in station two, station three, station four, and station five. Auto pick means it takes the object from station one, keeps it in the origin. Again, it goes to station two, keeps it in the origin. Then third station, it brings back to the origin, and so on. In between, this is an emergency button. Suppose if anything goes wrong, the moment you press this one, it is something like an emergency button. Everything will be stopped. All activities will be stopped immediately, because it is something like a safety thing I have put. So here also you see, I use this Sumkun model. Yesterday's PLC session I showed a 7-inch one. This is the 4.3-inch, bit smaller actually, but functionality wise all in the same, all are one and the same. Now if you see that, how many inputs I used? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 inputs I used, but PLC the physical inputs are only 8 for 14 MR PLC. Okay, so this is how we made we completed the project both using SolidWorks and PLC. Of course, we integrated the HMI also. See, one more point I could tell you. It is something seems to be small, but after the PLC, after this PLC, if you use a bigger controller, you can use it. You can even control not only the pneumatic cylinders, you can control even hydraulic cylinders. That means the power, that will be much more powerful. What I am saying is, even through this PLC, even you can automatically control the L&T JCB or poke line crane. Not a joke. It is possible. It is possible. Intermediately, you have to have a bigger solenoids. That is the only point. A bigger solenoid you have to use. That draw higher current. but same PLC is sufficient. Okay, so this is how we made this pick and place robotics arm. So I think with this you got some idea about how a product or a thing can be designed and modeled in CAD software, like parametric modeling softwares like SolidWorks, and how it can be programmed in PLC, and how we can use the HMI also, the human machine interface unit also, to control it so easily. Okay, so that's all for today. So thank you so much. Kindly subscribe my channel and inform about these things to our faculties and students, so then they'll also get some inputs through my sessions actually. Okay, so actually I am doing a small contribution for you people to just to know. What I'm telling you, teaching you, is only some basics or some small things. If we assemble all the small things, definitely you can do wonders actually. Okay, so that way my sessions will be informative, I think so. Okay, so you please see all my videos and give your comments, so then from my side I can do something for improving all these things. Thank you.